Thank you, Sheung. I think it's an important conversation we are having here, but I'm a little bit disturbed by the submission of the Attorney General of Federation, because what he described, I think they are the obvious things that the president is expected to do. He swore to protect the constitution of this country, and to do what he did is what he's expected to do. Are we to clap for him that he's doing what he's elected to do? No. So I think we're under what I would describe like a state capture by the executive that we have in the position to, in the government today. Because I remember what happened in Kogi, you know, when the president approved 10 billion naira on the eve of an election, and you are saying that you are promoting free and fair election, you know, against others that do not have any access to such kind of money, and this is supposed to state resources. So I think we have to be fair to this country, that we have a top-to-bottom problem in this country, not only in the election matter, but also other matters. And until we sort out the problem of the top, which is the people who are controlling the government, and in this case, in fact, even the National Assembly itself, you know, cannot be absolved from the blame here. Because why did they approve that amount of money that went to Kogi State at that point in time? Why did the National Assembly not pass a law or invoke a kind of punishment, some kind of sanction against the executive, when the executive refused to accede to the bill which the National Assembly sent to the executive on so many occasions to guarantee an environment that will produce free and fair elections? We remember that there was a president in this country that 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks to the election, he approved an amendment to the election which brought in this government that we are talking about today, which is the use of smart card readers. So if a president can approve amendment to the electoral bill 2 weeks to the elections, and you send a bill to a president so many times, and it will stand back to you, there must be something that is wrong. So I think we have to be very serious about how we regard the people of this country. We are not maroons. We know what we are doing.
All right.
It's high time that people in government wake up and rise to the occasion and take the right steps so that we guarantee free and fair election. Because it's very important to the survival of this country. If we cannot guarantee free and fair election, believe you me, we have a big problem going forward.
All right.
So, you asked a question as to whether the financing of the elections. That's why I'm telling you about what happened in Kogi State. You know, because how do you expect to have a level playing ground when such things are happening by the executive? So I think there's no free and fair election.
So
and I commend the INEC. I commend the INEC for promoting the establishment or the National Assembly, the establishment of the National Electoral Malpractices Commission. But before that, offences are committed because the grand norms are so loose. You know, if you don't have the grand norms that will protect, that will prevent, they say prevention is better than cure. So why not concentrate on introducing and promoting things that will guarantee free and fair election by way of having electronic systems in our conduct of elections, and then having the executive to buy into that. So, but I'm happy, and I thank God that the president today is a lame duck president. He doesn't have any collateral interest in what is happening, what is going to happen in 2023. So I expect him to write his name in gold by quickly giving assent to the bill, which we are told that by December of this year, it will get to the National Assembly will give us an electoral bill that will be able to guarantee free and fair.